Hello and welcome to the Computer Labs YouTube channel. So in this video I'm going to show you how to install the Nest Cam IQ camera, which is obviously manufactured by Nest, which is part of Google. So before we get to the actual install, a little bit about the Computer Lab. We are not sponsored by Nest in any way or Google in any way. These products are all purchased pretty much the same way as you would purchase your camera if you was buying one off the internet. But if you are thinking of buying one, please do look in the description below. That is a small affiliate link which will give us a small cut in this sale if you purchase one through the link in the description below. Okay, so back to the installation. I'm going to start off with the unboxing of the product just to see and show you what you actually get for your money. So the current price for the Nest Cam IQ Outdoor is about £320 or $350 if you are in America. You then have to, well, you don't have to buy, but it is recommended that you buy a subscription to their cloud service, which saves all the footage via the internet to a cloud service that you can access 24/7. They come in different models. I think the base model starts at 5 days, which is about £40 per year for 12 months worth, or about $50. Or you can actually go up to saving a month's worth in the cloud. They're both set up once you set your account up through Nest, once the camera is up and running. You do also get a free trial currently, which is included. I think it's a 2-week, 14-day trial of the particular service, and then you can just add on to that. Okay, so back to the unboxing. You can see here that you get what you get. Just pull the camera out and put it to one side. You get an instruction manual. But there is a nice app that walks you through the process. But this book tells you approximate heights, where to install it, how to install a backplate, and then stuff like that. So it's worth just quickly skimming through that before you get to your install. Okay, so what else do you get in the box? You get a 7.5 meter power cable. This is the power supply, which goes from the wall plug to the camera. And you notice on each end of the cable, they are labeled which end is to connect to what. So that was the end for the power supply, and this one has a little camera on, and that's the one that connects to the back of the camera. They also have little rubber ends on them that you need to take off before you install. But it's a nice long cable at 7.5 meters. Also has a tie wrap attached to it, which you can see there. You unravel that, so if you've got a bit of cable left over once you're installing, you can wrap that cable back up with the little tie wrap, Velcro tie wrap, that's attached to the pre-attached to the cable. So this is the power supply. It's obviously 240 volt UK plug with the USB-C power connector on it. And the only other thing you get in the box is a small box with some bits and pieces on. So just to show you, there's nothing else in there. It's just obviously all cardboard packaging. But yeah, getting back to the box I've just pulled out, that has some roll plugs in it and a small Allen key which unlocks the camera from its backplate. So this is the small Allen key that unlocks the camera, like I said, from the back plate. I'll show you that in a second and how that works. You get some cable clips, you get some stainless screws, 12 stainless screws, and the plugs, roll plugs to suit them screws once you're installing. They are a stainless screw, like I say, for outside, so they are a bit soft, so make sure you use the right head when screwing them into the wall. This particular camera is actually going on an inside of a warehouse, so I will be using the plugs but not the cable clips. There's a little protective cover that you need to take off once you get it installed. And this is the back plate, so it shows you how to remove the back plate if you click it into position. Google do, or Nest do, put a small little rubber in between it just to stop it locking when you initially get the camera out of the box. But that little Allen key goes in the hole there and unlocks the camera, the main camera, from the back plate that's attached to the wall. So this little back plate, like I said, it's on a rubber stop. There's a small spacer in between that they place just to stop it locking in place while it's in transit. But if you take that plate off, you can see there's a QR code. I've just got my finger over it for obvious reasons. Yeah, that's a QR code for adding it to your account once you get to that stage. Okay, so next we have the back plate that has the
protective blue sticker on. Obviously the ring like donut shape, that's the protective one that keeps it from locking in position whilst in transit. And the one I'm pointing to there just indicates if you put the camera on, where to put the Allen key to take the camera back off. For example, if you need to scan the QR code. But basically on that sticker there, it's just telling you to remove them both once you've got it out of the box and you start to install it. So you take the sticker off and you can see on the back plate there is a rubber disc and then you've got two exit points for your cable. One comes out the bottom and one comes out the rear. So depending on how you're mounting the camera, obviously you either go for the rear mount or the bottom mount for the cable. And you see there also the actual back plate has two flats on it, so you can't get the camera the wrong way around. You have to line them up once you are mounting the camera in position. So the way that Google advises you to install this camera is to put the actual Nest app onto your phone first and then scan your QR code off your particular camera into the Nest app. And then once you've done that, you can then follow the prompts, make sure you can get it connected to your Wi-Fi, and then find a position that your Wi-Fi can see the camera and that is suitable and has a strong enough signal so the camera can stream video from itself to the Wi-Fi and do that consistently. Okay, so let's get to the install. So the first thing you need is your back plate and you need to take the blue protective stickers off that I showed you earlier in the video, so make sure these are removed. And once you get them off the back plate, then you just need to find a suitable position for your mounting holes. Make sure you get a good fixing for the back plate to mount. I'm doing it with the cable entry to the bottom, but you can do yours to the top if you're going, say, into some up into the eaves. But find the four holes, mark them out with a marker pen. And once you've got them marked out, then we can get them pre-drilled ready for the raw plugs. So we're just going to speed this bit up, but basically you're drilling four holes to accept the raw plugs that you're using. You might be using a different size to the one supplied, so drill out the four holes and then put the raw plugs in the four holes you've drilled, ready to accept the stainless screws. So now's a good time just to offer up your back plate again and just make sure the four holes that you have drilled all line up, so you can just quickly double check that. And then, like I said, make sure you have the right bit in your screwdriver, because they can be a bit softer, these screws. So just get them started. And then what I tend to do is just obviously to give them a nip up with the electric screwdriver, and then I'll finish them off a bit later on just with a normal handheld screwdriver. So once this is done, it's now time to download the Nest app. Download it to your device, create an account if you haven't done already, and then push in the top right-hand corner where the cog is, scroll down to the bottom, click on Add Product. If you already got an account in, it will maybe add it to your already home account. So scan the QR code, offer it up to the back of the camera, the little QR code, wait for the ding, goes green and then it adds it. As you then, you'll need your Wi-Fi password, indoor and outdoor power sockets, and installation guide. Obviously, we skipped a bit of them because we are just going to do it all in one go. So next, you're presented with some predefined names for the camera that Google or Nest have decided to give you. You can also create a custom name, which I'm going to do. So obviously, scroll to the bottom, click on custom name. I'm going to give this one is warehouse, because that's where it's going in a warehouse. Then gives you some more precautions. Click on the continue button at the bottom again. And now we are ready to plug our camera in. So I mentioned at the beginning of the video, there are two ends to the 7.5 meter lead that comes with the camera. One that plugs into the actual camera side and one that plugs in to your power side. So just obviously weigh your lens up, how it's going to sit within the camera. Make sure you're happy with that, especially if you're clipping it to the wall, just so you know what's going on. There is two rubber protective ends on each end of the cable, so take that off before you try to click it in. And this then clicks into the back of the camera. It's a nice reassuring click and it locks in place once it's in there. To remove that, you have to push a little release catch. So make sure you're happy with it before you actually click it home into position. And like I said earlier, I just tend just to check these screws are tight and nipped up. So make sure I'm happy with them, just with a hand screwdriver, so not to strip any threads. And then once we're all happy to mount, we scan the QR code, we check the screws, we can now offer it up, offer the bottom in first, and just click it in to position. They are quite stiff, these outdoor cameras, so it's worth just being a bit forceful just to spin the head round. I have on the earlier ones especially, it was very strange just turning it within the sort of 360 degrees motion. But then now obviously we can position our camera, usually with a Nest label at the bottom, See how your cable's going to run, and then you can clip that to the wall. I'm not going to clip it to the wall at this stage. Just want to make sure that obviously keep this video running as quick as I can to get through it. So I will leave that loose for now. The other plug that you can see that's already connected in that power socket is for a separate camera. So I'll get the other end of your cable, and like I said, they are labeled with little blue stickers on each end. So this one on the actual cable should have a little sticker indicating that that's the power supply or the socket end. Also has the small Velcro which is wrapped around the cable, pre-wrapped when you get it, so you can tidy that up later date when you're clipping everything up and if get rid of any excess cables. Remove the little rubber cap off the end, and now we can just click that into position into the power supply. Just click simplest position, make sure it's okay. And now it's time to plug your power supply into the socket. And once it's plugged in, you can then power the camera on. You'll get a blue ring of light on the actual camera. And we also need to take the protective film off at this stage. So just take that off, just so when we test it in a minute, we can see a clear image. You can tidy the cable up now, but I'm not going to because I just want to keep this video moving. So. Yeah, so now it's time to go back to the app, and you can see we're ready to push continue. So push continue at this stage of your setup, and it will now try and connect to the camera. So you see here, I already have one that's called Outside Yard, which is already connected to this same account, and the warehouse one is the one that's flashing at the moment. So sometimes you can get an error at this stage, and it'll say it'll fail to connect, and you can sometimes think, well, maybe that's my Wi-Fi, and it might be, but in my experience, it's usually just been an error in the app side of it. And it's just a case of having to take the camera back off with the release tool that you're given and then start the process again through the ad product. And usually the second or the third time it will connect into your account. So we're just waiting for this one to add to the Nest account. So this part of the process should only take a minute or so, but once it is connected, we should get an audible beep, pretty much like this sound. And once you hear that beep, that is usually a good sign that the camera has connected into your main Nest account or your new Nest account, depending on if you've set a brand new account up on Google / Nest. So now we've got the green light added to your Nest account. We can now click on the next, get onto the next stage, and we should see a nice clear picture of whatever you're trying to cover with the camera. So you can see here now, so it's set, now it tells you in the Google app to bring your camera outside and plug it in, because it asks you to set the camera up, like I said earlier in the video, before you actually connect it to a wall. I've just connected it to the wall because I'm used to setting these up. Another thing to notice is if you change any of the settings within the camera, so there you can see I've just turned on audio recording within the camera, it will shut the camera down and then restart it. So you will lose the feed briefly whilst it just resets itself and turns on or turns off whatever you're adjusting within the settings. But once that has refreshed and restarted, the camera should come back live again, and then you should get a picture, like I say, of the camera coverage area. So now's the time to give the camera a twist and a turn and just tweak it to exactly how you want it, because you've obviously got a live feed on your phone or app or computer. So it's best to have it in position whilst you are near the camera. And then you can adjust it, change the angle, twist it within the 360 degrees, so rotation around the X and Y. And once you get it into position, you can then click on the next icon, and that should then finalize it into your account. So if you want to put familiar face detection on, again, you can switch this on. I'm not going to do for this particular account. I don't want that activated with these cameras. There is a secondary camera. So once we've clicked on the back arrow to go back to the main homepage, you should then get a nice clear picture of the either single camera feed or multiple camera feeds that you currently have. Okay, so that's it. That's how to set up and install a Nest IQ camera. I hope you did enjoy the video. If you did, please do hit the like button. Please do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to be alerted to any new videos that I do. And also do please check out the links in the description. This all helps in keeping my channel producing this type of video. And thanks again for watching the Computer Labs YouTube channel.